Good morning, good afternoon to you. How are you doing today? My name is Trygwin. I'm one of the network product managers and sales manager here at Zyxel. It's good to have you here. Today we'll be talking in this edition of Zyxel's Tech Talk about remote working. This is probably the most dressed up I have been all week long for work. I don't know about you. By raise of hands, how many of you are working remotely right now, working from home? Love to see who's all dressed and ready for work, right? Danny, thank you, Danny Stewart. So yeah, this is as dressed up as I've ever been for this past couple of weeks, I think. Really just when I'm doing these kind of webinars and stuff like that. But you know, it's really kind of a changing time. Everybody is now in kind of figuring out like how their daily activity looks like, things and you know, what to do, like how to get situated. And I think a lot of businesses have been kind of struggling with that over the last couple of weeks. And I know a lot of customers and a lot of partners have pretty much kind of thrown things together, just try to find a way to get remote access. And so I wanted to share with you today on how, you know, Zyxel brings forth solutions that can help you either to decide what is best for the applications that you're using and also how to do it securely as well. That's what we're mostly, at least that's where I'm mostly concerned in, because I am in the product management group of the security product line. And security for me is a very important part of maintaining that network. So Tech Talk is pretty much going to be, you know, a more interactive, I hope. That's why I tried to be a little interactive in the beginning here. So if you wouldn't mind using the Q&A to ask any questions throughout the whole presentation or the chat box as well, you can use that. I'd love to hear, you know, what you have. If you have questions, you have any concerns or whatever it is, love to discuss that in line with the topic. So again, I am from the North American headquarters here at Zyxel in Anaheim, California. So we've been isolated now. I think this is our third week working from home, but we're making do. And so hopefully everything is going to be, you know, smooth running. And we're also live on Facebook if you want to catch us on there as well. Obviously you see my green screen with our partner program on here, but we'll talk about more of our partner program in just a little bit. So let's go ahead and move into our topic today about transitioning your remote workers or your environment to like a remote. But I wanted to say, cover a little bit about who our company is, who Zyxel is. So we've been powering up over 100 million devices globally, making connections. We've been in business for over 30 years now. We just celebrated our 30th year last September. We have over 600 associates worldwide, 700,000 businesses working with Zyxel solutions, 150 global markets. Now you may have noticed the number maybe from previous time in terms of our associates worldwide is 600, a lot lower than what it used to be. It's because now we are called Zyxel Network. So we have two branches. One is called Zyxel Communications and one is called Zyxel Networks. It's focused on kind of the business channel, whereas Zyxel Communications is more of our telecommunications service provider arm. So that's why we're going to be called from here on out as Zyxel Networks. So just so you know, that's where you can see all the branding. It's going to be changed to that. So we've been internationally recognized for our innovation and design in global markets worldwide. So we have awards everywhere. Solutions are driven by our client needs. This is where we feel like we are special and different, working with partners like you, being able to have our own R&D, our own design, our R&D facilities worldwide that allows for us to deliver solutions to you that fit your needs as a partner. So if you're seeing, you know, hey, I have needs for certain applications, how to move to, you know, how to get to certain different markets or different functionalities, that's where you can work with Zyxel and you can work with us directly so that we can interface with our R&D to help build that ecosystem of products. And Stuart, you did ask, hoping to discuss about Chromebooks. Yes, we do. And actually, Stuart, we actually have some documentation now that it's been confirmed to work with Chromebooks. So I will talk about that in a little bit. We offer a comprehensive portfolio that offers an end-to-end delivery. So what I tell most of my customers is anything that connects to a network, whether it be wired, wireless, fiber, we have some sort of solution. Security appliances that do VPN, like we're going to talk about today. UTM solutions, SD-WAN solutions, wireless access points, connectivity with fiber, gateway, network management, all of that encompassed into one solution. So that's pretty much Zyxel in a quick nutshell there. So today we wanted to talk about how do you protect you and your business, especially when you're facing with, you can't really do this in the office right now, right? There's no collaboration face to face. So how do you collaborate? How do you deal with the situation that we're dealing with the pandemic? And I think what the pandemic pretty much has shown us is that we do have a weakness in terms of most businesses were not prepared. They were not set up to be able to work remotely. Now, luckily for Zyxel, we are a networking company. So in terms of just turning things on, it was all available, all ready to go. And most of us had already been geared or had been given the functionality to work remotely because we are traveling, you know, to visit customers and to visit our distributors, to our partners, whatever. We have to be able to work on the go. So we pretty much have had that capability already. So moving to a home network for us was really no different, except for maybe a few things like maybe our phone calls getting forwarded to our home or to our cell phone, but that was it. But it really kind of, I think most businesses realized that they did not have the infrastructure nor the capabilities remotely in a home office environment, or maybe even the internet connectivity at home to provide for that. And so that's why I think we see right now, there's a shortage of a lot of that kind of equipment. I mean, even webcams and microphones and all those kinds of things, even PoE injectors, those are all getting sold out because everybody flocked home and tried to get all those kinds of connectivities and try to make that interactive, capabilities still there. But so now a lot of the webcams right now, if you look online, a $60 webcam is going for $300. You know, it's really ridiculous. But how do you still get that collaboration? How do you still get that interaction with people and be able to do business, really? That's ultimately what we're all trying to deal with, not to shut down, right? So Zyxel, I'm happy to report our operations and our shipping is still open. We are practicing, safe social distancing within the shipping departments and everything like that to make sure that they don't get, sick or anything like that. But of course, all of the sales force, the tech support, we've all been moved into remote environments at home in order to serve you as partners. So we're still in that that mode of operation. And so we're here to serve you as best as we can. So really, how do you do that business from home? How do you enable remote access securely, quickly, easily? Well, what options are available, right? That's what we need to figure out. What hardware, what kind of new hardwares are available? Does my existing hardware even support? So there's like three things that we got to work on. We got to find out, does your office even support, this kind of remote access? Are the clients that you're using, the PCs, the end user devices, are they supported for any kind of remote access? And then how do you configure it? Is it easy to configure? Is it difficult or what? So here we got to take that. Why do you have to really, why do you want remote access? Now that's pretty obvious, right? We're moving the entire workstation. Everybody has to move, rebuild their office workspace. So, all of the monitors, people took monitors home from the office. They took their PoE phones. They installed soft phones. They took their laptops home. Any kind of hardware that they would have needed to work in normally in the office, they had to take home. But that also needed connectivity back to the office somehow, or maybe into the cloud. So there were, Windows machine laptops, Mac OSs, Chromebooks, and everything like that being taken home by students, by teachers, by businesses everywhere, right? So how do you get all those connectivity and how do you get them connected back? There's also another range of wireless devices out there too that also need access maybe to the CRM tools. Maybe there are some tablets that are used in order to access that, or maybe the home office user wants to be able to access those kinds of applications to do that through their tablets. So how do you manage tablets, iOS, Android, Chromebooks, again, needing that connectivity back into the office? So remote access kind of comes into different options and you kind of need an end-to-end solution. Obviously, I mentioned earlier, your office needs to have the capability or and also your home devices or whatever hardware you install in the home has to also support that as well. So remote desktop is pretty important. That's one of the easiest options. And I think a lot of users went to that route where there was a dedicated machine that was sitting in the office and you would use, remote desktop or TeamViewer or whatever it was to connect directly to that PC. And you were as if you were sitting in that machine. The only disadvantage of that is you're having to make sure that that client is available on both sides and you're doing just a client-to-client kind of peer connectivity within that network. So it does work. But sometimes it's you know, sometimes you may need to open up any kind of ports. You have to open up some firewall rules to make sure that it's secure. Or if something happens, if the computer freezes, there's no way for you to reboot it or anything like that. So you might get stuck in a situation where somebody has to still drive out there and maybe do some power cycle or whatever it is. So remote desktop is an option, but there are other options as well. You can use hardware-based VPN to either connect a, you know, to site to site. So if you have a multiple offices or maybe an office to a home office scenario from a hardware perspective, you can do that as well to make a tunnel between that. And all devices behind the device, behind the hardware VPNs can access, you know, resources between them depending on how you configure them. You also have an application like a software client VPN. That could either be a, you know, a client device like either IPsec or L2TP that is on a laptop or on a mobile device that is used to connect typically to a hardware VPN solution. So just be aware as well, there's a lot of information right now on the internet about, you know, software-based VPN. A lot of those are not necessarily doing VPN tunnels back to your office where you're needing resources, but they are more of VPN tunnels to the internet to kind of hide your, you know, hide your traffic or encrypt your traffic going out to the internet. So kind of be careful on where, you know, especially from your customer point of view, they may find these like, you know, Tunnel Bear or whatever it is to try to build a tunnel to their services. But really that's just kind of a proxy typically to get out. It doesn't really give you, you know, direct access into your office where you may have your CRM tools, your virtual machines and things like that. So that could also be a software that is installed, a little client that's installed in your browser, which allows and gives you web-based VPN. And so this VPN option uses pretty much your web browser to do the encryption, to make the secure connection, or it accesses, you can access the applications that are shared within the office environment or in that ecosystem. So it could also still be in the cloud as well. So things like email, customer management systems, your CRMs and things like that typically are in that web base. Now I'll talk a little bit about why, you know, maybe what the options, what are good, but let's see what is VPN. So I'm just kind of going to go back to a more simplistic view. So VPN is just virtual private networks. That's just the fancy name of making an encrypted tunnel between two points, right? Through an internet access or through a network access. In this particular case, it's through an internet connection. So you can use your home connection, connected to the internet, which then builds a connection to your headquarters or your office and does that securely. It's encrypted. So the traffic is using some of the state of the art, depending on your solution, military grade encryption. It encapsulates the traffic and then pushes it across the internet. So it is safe in that regard. There are different protocols that come into play. IPsec, you'll hear about IPsec a lot. L2TP over IPsec, SSL VPN, and also OpenVPN. These are different options that you have to make connections to a secure connection to your headquarters, but it has different applications. There's different functionalities that you may want to use one over the other. Full tunnel or split tunnel modes, these are used for full access connectivity. So in a full tunnel mode, you're literally sending all of your traffic from, let's say, your desktop from home through the encrypted VPN to headquarters, because you may do some sort of policies. You may need to do maybe content filtering that's required in your office space or in your application. So you can do full tunnel mode to send all that traffic there. There are disadvantages, obviously, because there are other traffics that may not need to go there, which is why there's a split tunnel mode. So you can actually define what types of traffic or maybe destined to the headquarters goes through that VPN tunnel. Whereas normal internet traffic, if you're just playing, you know, Hulu or whatever it is, because you can, though it's not encouraged, you could send it off to, you know, that just goes through your normal internet traffic and not through the tunnel. So you're not having to bog down the office environment. So that allows for you in full tunnel mode, it gives you access to printers, servers, file shares, as if you were just sitting on the network itself. And people always talk about, well, what's the advantages of doing that? Well, it is like you just plugged in an Ethernet cable. My analogy of a VPN is, imagine yourself having an Ethernet jack or Ethernet cable that's plugged into your computer, plugged into your laptop, and it goes all the way to your work and plugs into, you know, your network sitting at your desk. That's pretty much what a VPN kind of virtually does, but it uses your internet connectivity to do that. You can build site to site. which is going from maybe office to office. And in this case, it could be an office to a home office, right? So you can install hardware that is already in the office environment that has support for VPN, and then you install or deploy a hardware-based solution at the home. So it can exist and coexist with your existing network routers that are there to provide this kind of connectivity. So the advantages of that is that you don't need to have like client devices on anything that needs to go through that tunnel. And I'll tell a bit more about that. But some of the common applications, it depends on the applications. L2TP and IPsec are most common because those are all pre-built into a lot of your mobile devices. And that's what also you would use in the Chromebook. So we have the ability to, we have instructions on how you connect. And this kind of answers Stuart's question about Chromebooks is, we have instructions on how you connect it to an Android device. And so following the same kind of information, following the same instructions to do that, we can get it to work with our tunnels using, I think it's basically L2TP over IPsec, but for the Android. So you can use that for your Chromebook. Secure Extender doesn't support NAS. I need to check on that, Eric. Let's see, can I use, Marco asks, can I use a USG60 and USG310 for VPN with a fast throughput IPsec? Yes, if it depends on what you're doing. Now, if you're doing UTM and IPsec, then of course your throughput throttling is gonna be subject to your UTM throughput, right? It's usually the lowest common denominator. If you're doing purely for IPsec capabilities, then and you're not scanning the VPN traffic for UTM, then the VPN tunnel can be very fast. You have to look at the VPN throughput numbers on your device, and you'll see that usually even, let's say if it says 1,000 megabits per second, your VPN throughput will be 500 to 600 megabits per second. Now, the thing you have to look at as well is in your office environment. Most people have a lot of download speed, but they don't have upload speed, right? And that's where the end user is gonna need their, you know, for their downloads, is your upload. So if you have a very low upload speed, you may have a 300 meg, you know, down and a 10 meg up. That's what I have here at my house, you know, with my internet connectivity with cable service. It's 300 megs down and about 10 or 11 up. That's going to be the problem for most of these kind of remote cases. If you're trying to access that office to do a file share, instead of a 300 meg connection, the home user is going to get, or they're going to fight over and share a 10 meg connection. So we're going to be going back to our old days of a very low or slow download speeds. And if you can imagine, if you're going to stretch that out across multiple people, if they're accessing it live, then that content could be pretty, it could be pretty slow to getting there, but it may still function. Now, email, now unless there's like large attachments, may not be a problem, but there's something that you may have to already plan, or if you have not already, you may have to check to see how you can increase your upload speeds with your service provider or provide another piece to that. So there's different types of VPN, like I mentioned earlier. There's IPsec, L2TP, SSL. The easiest to set up is SSL. And this is actually the preferred method as, most ISPs don't block it in some way. There's some ISPs that will block your IPsec traffic unless you have like a public address to there. So you have to figure out, what you may have. You can build VPN tunnels through a firewall box, typically in a kind of a tunneled mode. That can traverse the NAT in that regard. So you may have to look at that kind of solution. But a lot of people, especially for the home office, if they're not looking for full tunnel, they're just looking for maybe access with a few file share servers in the office and maybe some CRM or email, like a web-based email, then SSL typically is that a best solution because the software on Windows is free. On Mac OS, unfortunately, there's a small nominal fee for a client that basically installs into it as an extension that gives you access through the SSL VPN. Now, the majority of the people who want the highest level of security and everything is IPsec. That is a paid client typically, unless you can find a free version somewhere. We offer a paid client on the PC, and on the Mac OS, you have to find, Zyxel doesn't offer a Mac OS IPsec. You have to find a third party VPN client for that. But good news is that our firewalls are ICSA certified, meaning that it's compatible with anything that is for IPsec, the standard that's available there. It's been tested and confirmed and certified for that. LTTP VPN is another option. It's not as secure, and in most cases it's not very secure depending on what your application is. Because if you're in the financial or in government, that's not allowed in a sense. But if you're just looking for, hey, I need some remote access to get access to files or some of my email, then you could still use it. And the good thing though, that it is native in most devices. So your tablets, your mobile devices, even Windows has it built into that client. So you can use that to make that connectivity. So IPsec, there's some pros and cons. So I wanted to cover that so that you can decide whether or not you want to go with the IPsec way, or if you want to go with an SSL option. So IPsec is the most secure. So it makes it harder for users to find a way to get into that system. You can lock it down, pretty well. In some cases, even for Zyxel, certain employees having access to certain systems, like our admin system, managing all of our network in our office, our IT has basically locked it down so that only the IP address of their home office is able to connect to our firewalls through the VPN tunnel to do any kind of maintenance or to do any kind of changes, right? Or even access the firewall at all. So that's where the benefit of IPsec comes into play. You can then put very controlled rules and things like that. It is also the fastest throughput option. So if you look at our data sheets, we posted our VPN throughput numbers there. So take a look at that to see what fits. But again, I think your limiting factor will be, and you may get complaints from customers saying, well, why is my speed so slow when I'm trying to grab a file? And typically it will be that the internet speed upload at the office is going to be the limiting factor. So you may have to deal with that, or you have to find a way to go around that through the ISP. But it's typically, because it is higher bandwidth, it's ideal for large file shares. So if you're, maybe there's a remote CAD drawer, or you're doing 3D rendering, you can able to grab in. It can be configured for full access as if you are sitting as a member of the network, meaning, like I mentioned earlier, you're able to do IPsec full tunnel mode. So as if you were sitting with an Ethernet cable at your office, so you can get access to all those resources that you normally would. And also IPsec is ideal to building that site-to-site, office-to-office, or office-to-home-office scenario with a VPN. And it can do a single VPN tunnel. So if I install the device here, which is, I'll tell you which model we'll typically use in a small home office, you can put multiple devices, your phone and your phone, maybe your laptop, your whatever it may be, can go through that single VPN tunnel that goes back into the office. The negatives about it, the cons are that it requires an IPsec client software for each of the devices that that you have to install. So you have to either have a endpoint client like the Zyxel Secure Extender VPN client installed on your laptop, or you have to get some sort of IPsec VPN client that's on your mobile device. It could be a little bit more complicated because of the settings that are there, but we do offer a wizard that will help you do on kind of auto provisioning, auto connectivity between those two locations. So it helps to configure the client device in a way that you can go through an email script or things like that. So we do try to make it easier to make those kind of connectivity. And also you need to have understanding of the network so that you block the resources you don't want people to have, right? Because it does offer the ability to give you full access to the entire network as if you're sitting on the LAN, if you're not closing it off or maybe limiting the users to certain IP ranges or even specific servers and things like that, it could cause problems if maybe their computer, their home computer, or their laptop gets compromised, then there's direct access kind of into your network. So we want to make sure that that's secure as well. SSL VPN supports, are supported in all of our Zyxel firewalls, as well as the IPsec side as well. They're already supported by all the browsers that are there. For Windows, it's a free client, like I mentioned earlier. For Mac OS, you have to purchase a license to enable the client. Simple to configure because it's just logging into a web page usually. So things like you're accessing the email, cloud storage, it's like you're surfing a secured bank site. That's really much it does. The IPsec, Stuart asks if the IPsec client is free for Windows. Yes or no? It is not. So if you're looking to do IPsec and you want to use Zyxel's IPsec client and that integration with our service or into our firewall, then you need to buy our client. Now you can use any other IPsec client out there in the market if you wish. Again, it's compatible with our products. Or if you're trying to build a VPN tunnel, you know, from the home, and maybe at your head end office, you already have another piece of hardware like, you know, a Cisco or, you know, whatever it may be in your main office, our products will also interface with that too, because it is ICSA certified. You just have to have the right configurations. And we have application notes and things like that that I'll talk to you about or tell you about that goes there. And yes, Huna, this is being recorded right now. It's also available on Facebook Live on our net, on our page, on our Zyxel page. So you can backtrack and watch it from the beginning if you'd like to. So, yeah. So it will also be recorded and we'll send that out, especially because I know some of you had some issues logging in to this particular presentation. Okay, so also it is easy to configure. So you configure it right for the different applications like your CRM tools, your emails, your cloud storage, and you can also control what applications have access. So you can choose in that web interface. Okay, if you can click on that, it takes you to your email. You can do that all via the SSL. So it makes it more secure because it limits down what the user has access to. And it's, you know, it's more simplistic. It's more simplified for those end users. Now the cons on it is that it depends on the client device. Sorry for the interruptions. Everybody's scrambling trying to find this webinar and they're asking if it's canceled and stuff like that. But luckily it's going to be recorded. We'll send it out. Again, I was confused myself on which one I was presenting on, but I'm presenting on the one that they told me to present on. So here we are. It's dependent. So SSL VPN is dependent upon the client device, and thus its throughput could be pretty low, because it requires your machine or maybe your mobile device to do the encryption itself and then send it across, right? It could, you know, even IPsec, there is some of that as well, but typically your browser connectivity to doing SSL is pretty low because it's not intended to send files and things like that. So we don't post the throughput numbers, but a lot of times what you'll find out is if you're trying to do file transfers through the SSL VPN, a lot of times it could be down to, you know, like 1 megabits per second to do that. So again, it's not ideal for that. It will still work. And then if you're kind of doing remote desktop type applications through the SSL tunnel, that also will be slower because it may be lagging a lot more. So if you're looking to do those kinds of applications beyond just like email and access to CRM tools and things like that, or web-based type applications, you might want to look at the IPsec version. And you may be encountering that now with a customer saying, hey, my user experience from the home office using the VPN tunnels or whatever it is bad. So you want to improve that. So these are some of the ways that can improve that. And Aaron, yes, I will send that out. Thank you. It is being recorded right now, Aaron. So once the webinar is done, we will also have the recording available and we'll send that out to all of our partners who couldn't make it into this one. But the other negative to the SSL VPN is that it cannot do site-to-site, right? It can't build a site-to-site tunnel. It can't do office-to-office kind of tunnels typically. So it's also limited to those specific applications unless you're using or you put it in a kind of a full tunnel mode. So we do have ways to work around it. But how do you work securely? How do you simplify that kind of remote access? So like I mentioned, we have that secure extender for SSL. So you use SSL on your Windows or a Mac, being able to access the web interface to log into a secured, you know, it looks like an intranet web page. And you can use it just like any web browser does. You click on some icons and things like that that you share, gets you to those shared folders, which then you can download. We support, our products support the L2TP over IPsec. So it's built into your browsers and that functionality into the devices. We also have an easy VPN wizard to allow for zero configuration, basically remote configuration of both devices or both client and office environments to make that connection to kind of minimize your IT resources in that sense, make sure that it's easier for you to make those connections and to set up those complex scenarios. We offer robust, secure IPsec VPN. And this is probably the one that I would recommend if you can do that, because it does give you that best throughput, gives you the best security and it uses some of the best encryption technology out there. We also, on the hardware side, do a few things to make sure that the connectivity is always there. Now, I did mention that, hey, your internet connectivity, your upload speed is probably going to be the one that is the most limiting factor. So not only that, is you want to make sure that your network, especially the office at this point, does not go down. Because if your office internet connectivity has the potential to go down, or maybe your service provider may have some bad connectivity, then productivity really would stop in that regard. If there is, you know, resources that are at the office that are, you know, critical to doing business, right? So we want to make sure that that's always available. So we have a function within our systems called VPN high availability. It allows for you to actually have the tunnels in a high availability mode. So when a internet connection goes down, you can actually connect to a different VPN tunnel through this system. So it makes it highly available. You can add WAN load balancing. Now that might be one of the solutions to your scenario where you may not have enough bandwidth and you're looking to get another ISP on board. You can actually bring on a second ISP and do load balancing failover. You can offer that kind of bandwidth, or maybe some people are connected to one of the WAN connections, and then the other employees are connected to the other IP address. And in case of failure, they can still switch over to the other, right? So we can still offer that kind of redundancy. Multiple WAN load balancing capabilities, and also virtual tunnel interfacing. So you can actually trunk multiple connections into a virtual interface, which then allows for the VPNs to build on that again, so that you can do load balancing between a single kind of point of VPN. So you can do that with multiple WANs. So if you can add, depending on your hardware model that you use at Zyxel, you can have three or four different WAN connections coming into your office to provide this kind of connectivity. But then you can make sure that it's always there. Now also, I'd love to announce here that Zyxel has taken measures on our side to also help with the scenario, because we know that most users are moving to the remote side and need access to the remote from the remote side. And we know that SSL is going to be the easiest option for you to set up. So what we've done is we've actually increased the SSL licenses for free that come default in all of our models. So the USG 40, 60, USG 110, 210s, those lower end models that have kind of the lower capacities, we've increased those, as well as our ATP product line. And this is a permanent increase. It's not just for a temporary time. And it's available on those models that you see here. It requires a firmware, though. We have a special dated firmware before it rolls into the main firmware. So if you want access now, we have that available. So you can just contact our tech support team, or contact our systems engineers to find out which firmware for which model you're using you need to download in order to gain this access. Now, in about a month, I believe, we will be releasing a full patch version that will come out that will include this increase. But you'll see, like, for example, if you already are deploying or you already have a USG 40 deployed in your office, before it came with five SSL client or SSL seats, concurrent SSL connections by default, and you could upgrade it. So you can increase it to 15 with licensing. So there's a one-time license that can increase it to that maximum number. Now what we offer is 20 by default, and you can increase it to 30 maximum on the USG 40. So we've increased it quite significantly in that regard in terms of the default value. So we're giving that to you. On the ATP series is pretty much doubling, or in the case of an ATP 500, it's tripling, or even ATP 800, we've put it five times. We've gone to 100 all the way up to 500 now. So we've added value to the product without any additional cost, any additional charge to you. So that hopefully will help in the situations where you need employees to get access to the system, right? And do it without having to pay extra. So if you either have customers who already have these firewalls, they can gain benefit already by just upgrading the firmware. Or if you're looking to deploy, these are really good value, obviously already at a great price point for the SMB, but giving them access to now load balancing, up to 20 concurrent SSL. Now, the number is concurrent. It's not the number of users per se, because you could typically have 50 people registered, or 50 people having accounts to connect via SSL, but only 20 of them can connect at a time. So just think of it like a bus, when you're taking a bus where there's 20 seats, right? And you can't put more people on there because they have to be seated. One has to get off before the other one comes on. So it's all about concurrent connections. So that's how you can load balance additional people if not everybody is on at the same time. So they can share the connection if you need to. But in a USG 40, just kind of put it on a relative basis, we typically recommend that for 10 or maybe 20 users or less. So giving 10 concurrent SSL VPN, that's going to be, plenty. Now, don't forget, there is already IPsec as well. So if you need to do LCTP over IPsec and also the IPsec VPN tunnels, those models already support those by default out of the box as well, with no kind of increase required. We've increased the SSL side, but you can still use your IPsec for hardware to hardware or even to the client device to that if it supports IPsec already. So we're just adding more capabilities, giving you more options to make that connectivity. But yeah, but if you have any problems, contact our support. We'll gladly get that to you if you need that. So let's take a look at our portfolio from a hardware perspective. So which models have which modes? If you're looking for SSL VPN, IPsec, or L2TP over IPsec, these are the models that are available. The VPN series, that's typically used if you're just wanting to add VPN connectivity to an existing network. Maybe your firewall at your office doesn't already have this, or if you're looking at using a VPN series model to deploy into the home office. So there's hardwares that allow for you to do SSL VPN, IPsec if you're connecting to the office, or L2TP over IPsec. So USG series is what you would use if you need any of these connectivities, plus security, right? You plus the UTM functionalities. If you're looking to also protect the office network for antivirus intrusion detection, content filtering, and being able to do those scans, the USG series is what you would move up to if you need that. Now, if you need advanced security, you need high throughput bandwidth while doing full UTM functionality, the ATP, our advanced threat protection firewalls, would supply for that. So that still supports the SSL VPN, IPsec, and L2TP. Now we also offer a cloud managed solution, our NSG series. So this could be helpful in the regards of if you're deploying maybe our lowest end cloud firewall to a home office or to an office where maybe you don't want to do a face-to-face install. You just need it to be connected. Let's see, Rick just asked, we need to contact support to get the firmware if we need it right now. Yes, absolutely. So we have a dated firmware there, Rick, that you have to use for your product. It's like a weekly firmware, basically, and it has that functionality in there. It's probably like 2 weeks ago that has that functionality. So just check with our support. They know which, they should be able to find which one is yours, or they will just give you the latest a week support firmware, and that will give you this functionality. But for the NSG series, it's cloud-based, so you could deploy it via the cloud. And so that may help in this day and age of social distancing and Amazon delivering or any deliveries just being left on your porch, right? You could literally send a install kit, a box for this, and all the user has to do is plug it into wherever they get their internet connection. And what will happen is the cloud solution will then call home and get either the configurations that's required that you've already preset, or you can remotely access it to configure it as needed to build a site-to-site, client-to-client, a site-to-site IPsec VPN tunnel. And then you can assign which devices, the laptop, MAC addresses if you want, whatever access networks, the phone, through that tunnel back to the head office. So you can manage that all remotely without even having to be there in person. So that's another advantage. The only negative, I guess the only piece that is that doesn't have is if you installed the NSG inside your office, it currently does not support SSL VPN tunnels. So you have to only build IPsec. But let's say you already have one of Zyxel's firewalls or even a third-party vendor firewall that's doing IPsec VPN tunneling. You could install and ship out NSGs to your home office, people who are working remote to their office or to their home offices, and have it pre-configured via cloud or, dynamically configured automatically. Or you can create profiles for that user and say, hey, this is your sales team profile that gives them access to a certain network in the office but it allows for their laptop to connect, their phone to connect, their soft phones, whatever it is. It's pre-configured that way so that when the device is installed in the home, it goes and grabs that configuration. And then the cool thing is you can clone that to your different sites. So each one of your teleworkers can have a different profile, but it's all cloned. So they have the exact looking, you know, kind of image, and you can do mass configuration changes and things like that. So there are some great advantages now that I kind of think about it a little bit more, how even though the cloud solution doesn't have SSL VPN, it could be a great possibility for you to be able to reach people that you normally are kind of isolated from now, including your own sales team. So on the VPN series, VPN 2S, the USG 20 and the VPN 50, these are probably the optimal ones that you may want to install into a home office. So let's say you already have capabilities in your business office side. You could send out or configure VPN 2Ss and these models here to be pre-configured to connect via IPsec VPN tunnel through an existing home network to your corporate office in order to build that tunnel. The advantages again to using a home off to using a kind of a hardware-based solution here is you could choose to have any of the devices that are connected to it via either Wi-Fi or via, you know, connection. It's via hardwired connection. You can choose very specifically which devices have access, because you wouldn't want necessarily, if you configured it wrong, you technically could get, you know, all of your devices, including your phone, sorry, your smart TVs, your anything that may be using your Wi-Fi home connection, going through the tunnel instead, right? Going to your office, but it might not go anywhere, but you could potentially configure it that way if you needed to, if you put it in a kind of a full tunnel mode for that network. Or you can make it as where this particular box is kind of branched out from your home network. It's plugged into a connection, but it's building its own private network, right, through the LAN. So it's creating another NAT interface, and you can build a tunnel through that NAT traversal. So it can traverse the NAT in order to get and build a VPN tunnel to your office still. So you could segment it out so that when you do connect directly to this box, or to these boxes, that it will be separate from kind of your home network. And that might be ideal as well. So it depends on, again, your scenario, your situation, how you, what kind of applications you're using within the home office that makes sense. The VPN 100 and above, these series are is what you want to add to your office network. So in an existing environment that already has a firewall, but maybe not full VPN capabilities, or maybe the capacity of your current firewall is not enough, then you want to check out these models. Because VPN 100, if you look at the bottom, the spec sheet there, it supports 100 IPsec VPN tunnels. It comes with 30 default SSL concurrencies, and you can increase it up to 200 maximum SSL VPN tunnels. And then of course, on the higher end that we just launched, our VPN 1000, it's getting more, it's going to be available towards the middle or end of this month. It supports 1,000 IPsec VPN tunnels. It comes with 250 default SSL, and you can increase it up to 500. So we have a range of products that will do that. So this is primarily for VPN connectivity. Now, again, if you want some sort of security with UTM, you can do VPN with UTM security. So if you already have an existing USG 40, it already has the support. Look at the throughput. The VPN throughput for a USG 40 is 100 megabits per second. So realistically, it's going to be about a 50 to 60 megabits per second throughput. So, but again, you may be limited by your upload speed anyways. I don't know very many people, unless they have some sort of synchronous connectivity that gives them, you know, upload speeds greater than 10 to 25 megabits per second. So, you know, make sure that that's available. It comes with 20 IPsec VPN tunnels. And now with the new firmware, it supports 20 SSLs by default, with an increase up to 30 max. And so again, it scales through the models, depending on which models you use. So a USG 40 and 60 could be also input into a home office, so where you may need security. So maybe you want some sort of protection for your employees because you're doing some sort of maybe more mission critical, or security is in your top priorities or one of your highest priorities, then USG 40s and 60s would be great with the UTM functionality and give you hardware VPN in the office or in the home office. Now USG 110 and above will probably what you would put typically in your home, sorry, your branch office, your headquarters office. In some cases, we've actually had customers use the USG 110 because of the higher throughput of the VPN throughput. So So that's maybe the only reason why you would go to a USU 110 at a home office. Rick just asked, can the VPN 2S be used without static address from the ISP? Yes, it can be. It should be able to do that because it will just build, you could either do a dynamic built tunnel. So even though you may not have a static IP address on your device, as long as you configure the branch office or your headquarters office firewall to accept a dynamic rule, then it will accept dynamic clients. So you can do that as well. Or the other option that you can do, Rick, is to use a domain. So you can use like a Dyn DNS that ties into that as well. And so you could build a tunnel using that as well. If you're using fiber, thank you, Stuart. Yeah, all of Verizon Fios, like fiber connections, they're synchronous. So you have the same speed up and down. So if you have the luxury of that, to have both the upload speed and download speeds to be the same, if they're synchronous like that, like you're using fiber connectivity, then obviously this will be very helpful. Or you may need to look for that kind of service, right? So you need to look for something that is more synchronous in order for you to get benefits of that. But I know a lot of the ones that are in the commercial business, and then that's where maybe you as partners will be able to help your customers, right? To figure out, well, this is going to last for a little while. It's going to last a lot longer than we think. You may want to still have this capabilities because this could be one of those things that recurs or happens again, where you might need to do this more often. Or you just need to have that capability anyways, at least, so that you can still function. So yeah, definitely take a look at that. Yeah. Most cable connections like mine are definitely asynchronous there. Thank you for that information and sharing that, Stuart. So in the higher end there, USG 210, 310, USG 1100s, those are also, higher capacity with more UTM throughput and, VPN throughputs as well, and more tunnels. So you can see that on USG 1100, 800 SSL default, 1500 max VPNs. And yes, we can go even bigger. So USG 1900 offers 2000 IPsec VPN clients, 1500 SSLs up to 2000 max. And then our beefy, really big USG 2200 has a 10 gig uplink as well, but it does 3000 IPsec, 1500 default SSLs, and it can be increased up to 5000 SSL. So these are your big boys if you're looking for, you know, massive numbers of remote access connectivity. But I would say, though, even with 5,000 potential max users, even with a 10 gig connection trying to share 5,000, that's probably going to be pushing it. So I still would not advise it, even though it's capable. I know most people will say, well, it's capable of 5,000, so I should be able to put 5,000. Yes, if you only want, like, you know, 5 megabits per second. You know, that's probably the drawback. And of course, our ATP 100 series or ATP series firewalls, these are our most advanced threat protection. So if you're looking to do sandboxing in security and zero-day threat security is a big thing for you to make sure that you're protected against, this is what I would recommend. The ATP 100 series is probably good for your home office or even the ATP 100W, offering a wireless connectivity there with 802.11ac connectivity. But it gives you 40 IPsec tunnels, gives you 30 SSL tunnels as well. But again, if this is not in your office environment or small office environment, this could also be used in your home because it does have that high throughput UTM and also high throughput VPN. So this is great for maybe like a 100 to 200 meg connection. That would probably be where you want to stay with this particular device. If you need to go higher, ATP 200 offers more tunnels. And also the default tunnels is increased there with more bandwidth. And then of course, in your office environment, your main office, ATP 500, we are launching an ATP 700 and then an ATP 800, which gives you 1000 IPsec, 500 default and max SSL VPNs. Marco asks, what does the 1 year gold security pack include? So the 1 year gold security pack is pretty much the entire system. It includes all of your UTM functionalities, your antivirus, malware protection, intrusion protection, content filtering, GeoIP blocking, access control, APs, the everything. So pretty much everything that is in the box is opened up as the 1 year gold security pack. So it includes 1 year of that service. And just from a pricing standpoint, every year subsequently is about 50% of that cost that you see on the bundle. 50 to 60%. So it depends on the model. So you know, that's where you want to go, especially if you're offering this as either maybe a managed service to the home. You can charge a monthly fee in order to provide this kind of service, not only from a security level, but also from a remote access. You can manage VPN, their VPN connectivity. Now we've also, you may ask, well, how do I configure all this, right? I've chosen the hardware. I've decided that they're gonna, I've done the mapping and to see, hey, they do IPsec, whatever it is. But we've created actually a business form. We'll send it out in a follow-up email to you all. But if you go to businessform.zyxel.com, there will be a category in there for work from home networking. You may have actually gotten an email already from our marketing department that talks about this. If not, you'll be receiving that soon. But it's a form that will actually help all of, you know, customers, partners on how to do installation, how to configure different scenarios. So you can find documents on how-tos and also get direct help from us, from Zyxel Corporate and from our support team and also the community on how to configure different scenarios if they're not already covered in our documentation. We're also there using the form to help troubleshoot, to support you if there are any questions. Of course, you can always call our tech support system. Unfortunately, they are a little bit overloaded because there's a lot of people calling into our support channels right now on this kind of topic. How to configure, what should I use? How do I get remote access working? Does my firewall support it, right? All of those questions are coming through our support team right now. So they're bombarded. I hope that you can have a little patience, you know, just give a little grace of patience there for them as they're trying to work remotely at the same time, trying to serve as many people as they can. So that's why we have these tools so that we can help you, you know, outside our normal phone support as well. But you can still call them if you need to. But we do have application notes. These are step-by-step documentation applications. You can find this actually in our firewall download section. So if you go to our webpage and you go to the downloads, the download section, you'll find application notes. I would advise for you to download that, take a look at that, because it has chapters in there that says how to configure it for, you know, Android, how to configure it for iOS, how to make a site-to-site, how to do SSL VPN, how to set up all of those scenarios. There's a lot of the scenarios. Even though the information may be a little dated in some of the spots, they still apply in terms of you getting you know, your configuration and how to configure your devices. But we are working on upgrading that to be of kind of the newer kind of content for that, but that's coming soon. But you could still use it to help in any of your deployments. So if you have Chromebooks and things like that, that was kind of been the number one question that people have had. How do I connect the students or even the school, a teacher Chromebooks that they've been sent home with, how do we connect them through VPN so they can access the school's network like they usually have before? So that's one way to be able to connect it. So the short answer is that you would use the same way you connect Android devices to connect your Chromebook because they are basically Android-based. There's more detailed training as well. So April 7th, so next Tuesday, we'll be sending out, and if you may have received it already, we have a webinar that I'm collaborating with our systems engineer, Marcus, and he's gonna be presenting more of the nuts and bolts on how to actually go in, look at which screens, kind of best practices, the screenshots on how to configure these different scenarios. So he's gonna cover, you know, building an SSL tunnel or setting up your office for an SSL tunnel, and then what to configure or how do you configure the client side. And then also how to do site-to-site IPsec, right? So how to configure all that, maybe using the wizard tools and things and pitfalls and things like that that you may want to go in. So definitely sign up for that. It's April 7th, so it's next Tuesday at the same time as we do this one at 11 a.m. Pacific. So we're going to be going over the configurations and best practice of that. So definitely go into that community forum here and you know, you can read on it, also post anything that you need help with, and we're there to help. We've also created kind of a spreadsheet quick guide, kind of help you look at, well, which devices support, you know, which tunnels, how many tunnels it has. So we're going to make this available as well. Our marketing team is going to be sending this out in an email with information with the link to that business forum, but it allows for you to see which models support how many tunnels, how many does it support LTTP, what is its max concurrent tunnels, what is its default? How much are the upgrades for the additional tunnels, et cetera, if you're looking to expanding the client? And then also from an IPsec and SSL standpoint, how much are those client devices and what is supported within those systems? All right, so we're gonna be sending that to you. And also if you have not yet been part of our Zyxel program, we have what we call our Zyxel, the Zyxel program for authorized resellers. So Zyxel authorized partner, that's our ZAP program. So we're here to jumpstart your business into profitability because we offer through distribution, those are the distributors that we currently use here. Through distribution, you can be getting anywhere between 16 to 20% off of the off distribution pricing. So if you have not yet signed up, I inquire for you or I ask you to go and do that. I encourage you to sign up because it doesn't cost you anything. All it requires for you to maintain the silver pricing, which is where you'll be at when you first sign up, you'll be offered at, you need to maintain a 6K in a 6 month period. So that's 1K a month of business with Zyxel in order to get 16% off. So that is great because you could still, and that 16% off will allow for you to still be, at, visible price, like what you find on the open market and still be making double digit margin. So we encourage for you to do that. Of course, we want you to get to the gold. We've been working with a lot of partners that are successful in moving from silver to gold. So we continue to want to look and grow you to there because that gives you the most margin, gives you that and access to a lot of different things as well. So at this time, it is a Q&A section. So I thank you for, if you are want to stick around for the Q&A or if you have any questions, please use the Q&A. Thank you for your interaction and going through this. I'm glad that you were able to find it. Sad that a lot of other people couldn't find it because of the link issue, but we'll definitely get it recorded. If you have any team members that are interested in this or you know people who want to watch this recording as well, that will be available. Or you can watch it replayed on Facebook Live after we go, after we end the stream here. So if there are no questions, again, thank you so much. If you want to email me, if you have any comments or you have any questions, feel free to email me. My email address is try@zyxel.com. I know there was a lot of things to cover. And so I covered a lot of the high level stuff. We can dive into the details and configurations and things like that on Tuesday. So make sure you look out for that webinar for Tuesday. We'll send out the link to that webinar as well when we send out the kind of the notice of this recording. Rick has a question. RDP through SSL is inconsistent at some of our clients. Would VPN2S stabilize that? Yes, absolutely. Because that's one of the big issues, Rick, with remote desktop is SSL VPN through your browser is really slow. In a lot of cases, it's like single digit, megabits per second or even worse. Depends on the encryption level that you're doing. And so it's not ideal to do remote desktop where it may need, an image that's being sent. And of course, everything is all like, it's all, jerky and it's really hard to use at that point. So the connectivity usually is not good enough for that. So using a VPN2S to build a hardware IPsec VPN tunnel will allow for you to do that much cleaner. And so even if you were to just install an IPsec client onto that machine to do, the RDP, then that would work as well, but it still depends on, you have to go and install that. Now, if you deploy and just send them, hey, here's a VPN2S, just put this into your LAN connection, plug the WAN into the LAN, we'll take care of the rest or what's already pre-configured. We can remote desktop to it or whatever, or remote access that, it will do that. And the other option also is to use like a NSG50 if you want to use the cloud version or cloud way of getting there. But I know for the VPN2S, basically the VPN2S could be a good option for that too. Chromebooks, L2TP, where are the details about this connections? Stuart asked, Stuart, it's in that, if you do go to the downloads, if you go to the VPN models within our website, you can go to the download section and look for the application notes. Inside the application notes is an L2TP or even connection for Android that you can follow. Or what you can do, Stuart, is you can also contact our support. We confirmed with them yesterday with one of our techs there that he had gotten it to work before. So you can also reach out to them and just ask them specifically on the support side, how do I connect my Chromebook? I've heard that you guys can get it. The support team here in the US have gotten it to work using Android instructions. So yeah, just find out from them and we would be able to help you. Or if you want, Stuart, you can send me an email, try@zyxel.com. I will forward it to the support team or a systems engineer that will find you that documentation for you. So if you can't find it yourself, we can also help you there as well. Okay. Well, I'm going to drop off now. Hope that you guys stay safe in all of your endeavors while you're being isolated and trying to do work. But here we're here at Zyxel here to help you to try to find ways to make sure that your customers or yourself or your business can continue to function and continue to do work and still stay in business. There's a lot of businesses out there that cannot do what we do, right? Cannot do what you and I are doing from a remote access standpoint. They have to do face-to-face business, or you know, they're in brick and mortar, that kind of thing, where there's nothing they can do about it. So here, luckily we're in a kind of a technology and a networking where it's essential that we make sure that the connectivity of our customers can be available so that they can do business, so that we can stay in business, right? So it's going to be this whole ecosystem that we're all part of. And so look forward to finding ways that we could help at Zyxel, and hopefully the expansions of our SSL connectivities can help with your existing customers that may already have Zyxel products in place, or gives you a good talking point, you know, and from a price points perspective, from a capacity standpoint, to getting people connected, not only connected online and through this remote access capability, but doing it securely. So again, I encourage you to take a look at that ATP series, at least the USG series. But if you already have a firewall, then the VPN series is perfect for that. So we have solutions that can fit all those kinds of scenarios. So thank you for joining. Have a great rest of your day. It is now the afternoon. So I could say have a good afternoon here from the West Coast in California. Stay safe. Hope to see you next time. Sign up for that webinar on the 7th. We'll be sending out information on that. So if you, again, have any questions, contact me. Feel free to reach out to me. I'm sitting at this desk for long periods of time, getting up only to eat and things like that. So I'm lonely. No, I'm just kidding. I'm having a fun time. So thank you for the interaction. Thank you for being here with us at Zyxel. And we look to being your networking partner here at Zyxel Networks. Thank you again.